Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. I'm not a cat. I don't say meow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. I go moo. Moo. Got steak ho, got cheese,
got it.
Great A-ho, not lean. Got me A1, sauce please. These heifers got nothing on me. Steak's high, need a side of color greens.
Alright, so to get started, you're going to need a long sleeve white shirt. I actually got this at the girl section of the thrift store, and then I went over to the men's section and I got this extra large t-shirt. And you're going to want to make sure they're about the same thickness and fabric and like the same weight and all that, just because you don't want one to be too thin, like your skirt to be too thin versus your shirt being thick. So make sure they're the same weight. And then, of course, you're going to need a skirt as a pattern. Any old skirt should do, so long as it's body hugging and just form fitting to you. So you want kind of like a bodycon effect. And then here I'm showing you the textile medium from Ceramicote. I got that off of Amazon, and then black paint that I got from Walmart. You can use black fabric paint, but this is just a cheaper alternative to that because it can be kind of expensive. Of course, you're going to need some paint brushes, and then you're going to need your Sharpie for writing and such, and straight pins. And what else? Scissors. Yes, of course, scissors. So starting off, I went ahead and turned my shirt inside out so that I can draw as well as eyeball where I wanted my neckline to be. And I kind of just did this V-shape neckline and then carried it down because, you know. Anyway, so I also marked where my belly button, right above where my belly button is. And I just carried that line downwards. And this will just help me know how much I should cut off from the bottom. So this is what it looks like after we're all done. So we're just going to go ahead and cut off all the excess and also cut off that excess at the bottom. So I'm just here, I'm trimming off all of the excess pieces. I've said that like 3 times, but yeah, just so y'all know. And make sure you're only cutting on one layer, aka the top layer, and not the bottom layer, because you don't want it to be in half. So yeah, just cutting that V shape out. So from that excess piece from the bottom, we're just going to cut that in half and then open up that circle and cut it in half again, so that we're creating 2 straps, which we'll use later for our front strap pieces. But for right now, we're going to go ahead and hem everything down so there are no raw edges. So hemming the V-neck and then hemming the bottom, just folding it in. I only folded the V-neck once. The bottom, I think I did twice. Yeah, so I did like a rolled hem. So remember how we gave a little bit more of that excess, going right above our navel. So you definitely want to give it about like an inch worth of seam allowance so that you can roll that up. And you can double hem that, if that makes sense. So, and then just pin everything to place. So moving on into our skirt, I'm gonna take our larger t-shirt and just flip that inside out. And then I'm gonna place our skirt on top of it, using that as a guide or pattern for which we're gonna create our bodycon skirt. So yeah, now this skirt I'm using is actually a little too big. If you do use a stretch skirt as your guide, you do want to add seam allowance. But if you're using a skirt that is actually like pretty fitted to you, but like, you know, has a little bit of give, you don't really need seam allowance, I feel like. But as good practice, is always good to just add it just in case. And then if it is too loose, you can go ahead and take it in. And here you just see me pinning it along the sides. I already kind of got a little excited and started cutting, but definitely just want to pin everything in place before you start cutting. And then once we're finished that, I actually went ahead and cut off more because, like I said, I like my stuff very, very skin tight. So I made it a little bit more of like less of a flared effect and more of like a hip looking skirt. You know what I mean? So I just repinned everything, and yeah, that is basically it. We're going to now take everything to the sewing machine I think, right? Yeah. Oh, no, no. There's a step before that. So using the sleeves from the larger shirt, we're going to make the bell sleeves for the new shirt. So I just cut off the sleeves. And then later on, I went ahead and I added some more, like another layer of sleeves. But I'll show you that in a little bit. Now here I'm just sewing everything into place, and you just want to go ahead, quick tip, you want to make sure you're using a sharp needle as well as polyester thread, especially when you're using stretch fabrics. So here you see me, I'm just hemming everything and hemming the straps. So yeah, use polyester thread and a really fine needle, because it will be very difficult to sew through t-shirt fabric, and I've had many a trial and error doing that. So yeah. And so yeah, I'm just hemming the straps, making sure there are no raw edges except for the one that we're going to be attaching, as you see here, to the actual shirt. So the raw edges are going to be facing on the inside anyway, so you don't have to worry about hemming that. And then you just want to make sure right sides are touching, and that when you flip it, it looks nice and neat on the other side. So now we're going to go ahead and pin it down and just take that to the sewing machine and sew that up. And then I'm going to go ahead and finish up the skirt, sewing up the sides. And we are also going to make sure to do a quick roll hem on the top portion of the skirt, because remember, we use the bottom part of the larger t-shirt, so we didn't really have to worry about hemming both sides or both ends. So just where we cut, we have to hem. And then I also did this to the little sleeves that we cut off, so there are no raw edges whatsoever, just so it looks all nice and neat. And then this is where I'm gonna be a little confusing, because I did not get a good angle of this, but I basically use a very long stitch. This is called a basting stitch. And you just set your machine to 5 in terms of your stitch length. And I'll definitely link a video down below on how to do a basting stitch, but it's pretty easy. You can also do it by hand. But here I'm not really showing it in very good detail, so I'm gonna definitely link that video down below to show you how to ruffle things using a base stitch. So I apologize if that was not very helpful. But if you do want a separate tutorial on that, I can definitely do that, but I will, like I said, link it down below. So here I am attaching the sleeve. There we go, words. Attaching the sleeve, making sure that my my shirt is right sides out, and then my sleeve is upside down and inside out. So wrong sides are out, upside down, and that way I'm pinning it to the cuff. And then I'm taking a stretch stitch, which is number 2 on my machine. And this is really good for stretchy fabrics that you don't necessarily have to use a zigzag stitch for. I learned this from my girl Jess, so thanks, girl. And so now I'm not even pulling the fabric when I'm doing this. It's just a simple straight stretch stitch, which is really, really helpful for this kind of project. And then here is where I made the extra top layer of the bell sleeves. So you can see in the video, she has kind of like a double layer of bell sleeves. So I just went ahead and repeated the same process, but I had to make them from scratch rather than cut off the sleeves. And we just made these kind of trapezoid looking shapes, and then sewed up the sides, hemmed everything, and then did another basting stitch to gather and ruffle that sleeve. And then instead of, as you'll see a little bit later, instead of machine sewing it to it, I just went ahead and hand sewed it, because it was just going to be way too complicated to try to get that through the machine. So yeah. Alright, so here is the relaxing part. So now we're just going to go ahead and mix 2 parts of the acrylic paint to 1 part of the textile medium, and then just mix that up. And now we have our fabric paint ready to go. And with this, y'all, just go crazy. Just enjoy and have fun, because there's really no right or wrong way to paint cow spots. I don't know if that's what they're called. But yeah, I didn't even look up a reference, because I was like, whatever. Like, this is how I would like it. And yeah, just have fun with this part. And then so I did the skirt first, and then I went ahead and did the shirt. And I will say that this definitely took a little bit longer than I thought it was going to take, but it was very relaxing. You could definitely just throw on a movie, you know, grab a glass of wine and, you know, paint away and have a good time. But yeah, this is what it turned out to be. And y'all, this is definitely a mood. That was so corny. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Of course, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I love you all, and I'll see you in a new video. Bye.